all praises, all honor, and all glory unto the Most High YAH. I truly thank Him for your lives, and you are all welcome. All right, so today I'm going to be talking to you about, as you can see the title here, I'm not sure exactly what I'm going to entitle this, so it may be different than the title, so hold on and listen, okay? But it's been a while. I pray that you all are doing well on today. If you're not doing well, I pray YAH's grace, I pray His peace, I pray His strength, I pray His help, all right? In whatever area you need Him to be your help, I pray that He will be just that for you. He's already that. I pray that you will receive it, okay? If you need healing, if you need peace, if you need joy, if you need strength, if you need finances, if you need to know how you're going to make it through the day, I pray that He will give you wisdom, knowledge, and understanding and strength. If you need help just getting out the bed, I pray that He will be just that you need. All right. And so you're welcome. I truly thank y'all for your lives. So today I want to talk about some current events. I do. I'm not going to name them. There are too many to name. I do want to say that I welcome everyone to the channel. I do. All right. There's no discrimination over here, but there's no delusions either, right? And I think that a lot of people are self-deluded because they try to avoid reality, the reality of what is going on in this nation, what has been going on in this nation, and what will continue to go on. And one of the things I want to talk to you is about some videos that I've viewed this week, right? And so, not so much about them, but what happened after I viewed them. Well, there are a number of videos. I can't even tell you all of them that I watched, with some crazy stuff going on, right? But after I got through, there was someone that was present with me. After I got through watching a couple of them, I said, you know what's crazy? I said, you won't believe this craziness. Listen now, okay? So I want you guys to listen. I said, these people have been held captive, all right? Kidnapped, held captive, all right? On these people's property, and they were basically slaves in the place, right? I say they have been held captive, and now the person has let them go. After all these years, the person has let them go, and instead of them leaving, they are there arguing with the person, all right, concerning their right to stay there. Now, is that not crazy? I mean, we see people getting shot. We see people being murdered in the streets. But I think this one right here is the craziest of them all. Okay? So someone has kidnapped you, brought you into their home, brought you on their land, kept you there as a slave. And they have finally let you go. And the person doesn't want to go. They want to stay in the place and argue with the people over their right to stay there. And so I was telling the person about, you know, about that. And they said, that's crazy. That's crazy. I said, what do you think about that? They said, that's crazy. What's wrong with them? And I said, there's something definitely wrong with them. They have their freedom. I said, and they said, well, why do they want to stay? And I said, they want to stay because they found out that the person that kidnapped them didn't own the house. So, because the person that kidnapped them didn't own the house, didn't own the land, actually killed the owners. Yeah, killed the owners and took them captive and brought them into the house and made them a slave in the house. They had children with the person and everything. And so now they don't want to leave because they feel that because the person doesn't own the house, they have a right to be there. And I guess because they've been there for so long. And so I was telling it to the person who saw me watching the videos. And they said, yeah, that's crazy. There's something wrong with that person. They need some help. So then I picked up the phone. I called my sister. So I said, let me see what she has to say about this. So I called her and I told her what was going on, because I knew she was going to give me her professional opinion, you know. And she went straight textbook on me, and she started giving me all these clinical reasons why the person is doing this, and, you know, saying that they need some transition therapy and all sorts of stuff, you know. And I said, yeah, it's crazy. It's really, really crazy. And so when you're listening to all these wild stories that's going on in this nation, I said, this has to be the craziest. And she said, yeah, they really need some help. So after I listened to you know, a couple of people. I said, guess what? And they said, what? I said, thou art the man. Thou art the person. They're like, what are you talking about? Well, the first person knew what I was talking about because they knew scripture. My sister didn't know what I was talking about. So I said, you're the person. You're the person that needs transition therapy. All right. And to the other person, I said, you're the person that's behaving in this crazy manner. You are that person. And they said, what do you mean? I said, because you have been brought here to this nation. Your generations prior to you have been brought here, have been kidnapped, have been held in this place. All right. Have been enslaved. All right. And now you have been set free. But because you feel that you are invested in this nation, because you have put your generations have put blood, sweat, and tears, your ancestors have died and suffered and built up this nation, you feel that you have a right to stay here because you found out that master don't own the land, that master didn't own it, that he actually killed people to take possession of it, he killed Native Americans to take ownership of it, and so you feel that you should stay here. And that you should have just as much right to own stolen land. You feel that way because of the time that you spent here and the children that you bore, even children that you bore through to master. You feel that you should stay here. You see how crazy it is? It's easy for us to diagnose the situation when we are outside of it. We can see so clearly how crazy it is for us to really think that we are justified. Or it's crazy for us to think that it's okay to continue to stay and fight for something just because we found out that the person who brought us here doesn't own it. That's crazy. That's craziness. Or because we feel that we have put time in and we put sweat in and it's just as much, we have just as much right to it as them. That's crazy. What about the people that own it? So I just wanted to share that with you all. This will probably be a temporary share, but I just wanted you to see just how crazy this whole thing is. It is. We are in need of some transitional therapy for real. Okay. So after I shared this with them, that they were the person that they were describing, they were the person who was thinking irrationally, who was thinking crazy, who needed some transitional therapy, who had begun to identify with their captor. All right, they could see things better. They could understand the situation. Now, of course, there was the but. All right, the diagnosis has already been made. They had already diagnosed the situation when they didn't see themselves in that situation. When they were looking at it from the outside as if it were someone else, they could see it clearly. But when they put themselves in that situation, then that's when they started to make excuses. All right. So that's when they started to make excuses for why it was okay, or perhaps this is the reason, or, you know, just giving all of these excuses and explanations. When the truth of the matter is what they diagnosed earlier. This is crazy. This is madness. This is insane. This is unbelievable. This is someone who truly needs some transitional therapy. Selah. And Yah, help us to see, all right, and to act on what we see. Take care.